The yogi who has spent years practicing and has gained a high degree of mastery over both mind and body is said to have achieved a high level of attainment, to have become a highly realized being. Their powers are sometimes said to extend into the realm of the paranormal. Such supernatural stories have swirled around the Tibetan yogis throughout their history, thickening the cloud of mystery surrounding them. Tales of telepathic communication and mind-controlling matter are reported among advanced practitioners to this day.
I have nothing to tell you. This is the first time I've been asked to tell about these things. We are not supposed to reveal the ins and outs of what goes on inside a meditation cave. If we do, then there will be consequences. The past masters, including Tilopa, have categorically said there was never an instance where he revealed the secrets of meditation. We who follow in their footsteps must do the same.
Although it is known that Juang Rinpoche did cut his hair in preparation for death, His Holiness the Dalai Lama asked him to live a little longer to help pass on and preserve Tibetan teachings. It is said that His Eminence agreed to do so and has decided to live until the age of 100 to help his people. Beyond feats of mental, physical, or even supernatural control, perhaps the most impressive accomplishment of the Tibetan yogis is maintaining a stance of compassion and peace through a half century of persecution. The teachings of loving your enemies and praying for those who persecute you are familiar in the West, but are, few would argue, among the hardest to practice. Skeptics may well point out that feelings of love and peace may be easily generated when you are by yourself in a cave, but not when you're coping with the human conflict inherent in real life. Yet, the claims of the Tibetan yogis have been put to the extreme test in the Chinese Holocaust. How does one retain compassion in the face of raw cruelty?
As some use the ancient, the text stated or says, the one's own enemy is the best teacher. Now, one example. So an old monk who in previously the Namjian monastery, one monk of the Namjian monastery, he spent almost 18 years in Chinese gulag after 59. So after he released camp, eventually he joined with me there. So then one day I casually asked about his experience in the gulag. Then he told me that a few occasions he faced some danger. Then I asked, what kind of danger? I thought danger of his life or something. Then he answered me, danger of losing compassion towards Chinese. So that's we as a practitioner, we deliberately try to keep compassionate attitude towards one's own enemy is very essential.
I don't blame the people of China. I blame their policy or their culture, because it's a communist culture. The culture is at fault, not the people.
Thank you.
Swami.